South Africa Sevens coach Paul Treu. Paul, describe to me the feeling when you touched down on the runway here in Hong Kong.
I think maybe just to start with, maybe a bit of uncertainty because, and also, I mean, if you take into account that we've been here so many times and, you know, almost like for 20 years, and for 20 years we've left Hong Kong, you know, in an unhappy team. And I think also coming back, you know, from a very successful tournament in Vegas, and knowing that, you know, five tournaments, five different winners, that there's no guarantee this weekend that the team that won the last tournament is going to win here again. So I think, you know, in terms of that, is a bit of a mixed feeling this coming week. Not quite sure what to expect. And we've been talking about that our whole camp, you know, how we can keep it up and how we can keep building the momentum. So don't know what to expect this weekend. Yeah, but we're just going to take it one game at a time like we always do.
You were the winners last time out in Las Vegas, the USA Sevens. You rose to the challenge there. You had time to reflect on what clicked in Vegas, what you did right?
I think that is what we've discussed with our players, that it's so easy, you know, to learn from a loss and to learn from failure, but to learn from success, you know, is very difficult to do. And I think in a sense, it's almost like you're expecting to win again. And I think that's maybe the lesson that all our teams, you know, can take out of, you know, winning tournaments this season. But I think, you know, it's just that desire and that hunger to win and just to play for each other. And I think that was the only difference. There was nothing, you know, significant that we've done differently in Vegas that we did for all the other tournaments. In fact, if you look at the statistics, I mean, you would see that we're dominating the series. And anyone looking at the statistics, and we've said it in Vegas as well, should be saying, you know, but this team is probably, you know, top of the log, but we're not. And I think that is what we've discussed with our players. When we're making mistakes in the games, it's expensive mistakes. You know, whereas New Zealand and Fiji and Samoa and some of the other countries, they're making mistakes, but it's the cheaper ones. You know, it's not costing them tries. And I think, you know, once we started to focus on the small things and just to up our focus and awareness in the games. But like I said, it comes down to the desire, whether you want to win a tournament or not. And I think the guys wanted to win that one in Vegas.
So how much do you want to win this one for the first time?
Well, I think, you know, we said it, you know, for the first time, we would like to enjoy the fireworks and not watching the fireworks. And I think it's going to be up to the team what they want to do. Because, I mean, we as coaches and as management and support staff, I mean, we can do as much as we want. But it's up to the players, you know, whether they want to go out there and play this weekend and hopefully win the Hong Kong tournament for the first time in 20 years.
And you've been here as a player. What is it about Hong Kong?
I feel for new players, you know, playing their first Hong Kong tournament, because I think it's just the whole vibe and the atmosphere and everything that's getting to you. I mean, 40,000 people, most of the time when new players come here and they play their first tournament, is like they just taken aback, you know, by the moment and just by the atmosphere at the stadium and just the noise and the buzz. But yeah, I think it's because of the hype of the tournament. You know, it has always been regarded as one of the biggest tournaments in the world. And I think the pressure is getting to the players. And I think if they can stay cool, calm and collected, then hopefully we can go all the way.
We're at the sixth tournament here in Hong Kong. We've had five tournaments. We have five different winners. What do you put that down to this season of all seasons?
I think it's a combination of factors, because, I mean, there's so much to play for. You have promotion, relegation at the end of the season. You know, teams would like to retain their core team status. You have teams who would like to win the series for the first time, and then you have teams, you know, who would like to win it for the second time, or maybe like New Zealand, you know, won it for so many times. But I think, you know, the standard of sevens, you know, in general and just worldwide, the profile of sevens has elevated to such an extent that you every team is now professional. Every team is putting a lot of resources behind this, their teams and their preparation, and that is why the teams are becoming more competitive. It's the desire of those countries, you know, to unsettle and to upset, you know, the bigger countries and to really to claim their stake in, like, on this level. I think it's testament to the fact that the IRB has done so much for sevens, you know, worldwide, that we're starting to see that the smaller countries are really coming to the fore and making their mark, you know, on the international stage.
Three teams are going to have to rebook their core team status next year, and 12 teams here in Hong Kong are trying to keep their hopes alive of being core. Zimbabwe are one of those. They're playing in this 12-team tournament. What do you make of this 12-team tournament, and what do you make of Zimbabwe?
I think it's going to be one of the most competitive tournaments, you know, for those teams. And we played Zimbabwe just a week and a half ago, and I can promise you, I mean, if it wasn't for our defensive effort, you know, we would have lost that semi-final against Zimbabwe. in those teams, you know, they have something to play for. I mean, to be part of the series, I mean, that is what any team aspires to be and where they want to be. And I'm sure that they're going to go out there and try everything in their power, you know, this weekend to make it to the final playoffs. But just to come back to the competitiveness, you know, of Sevens worldwide at the moment, I think in the past you had maybe 10 core teams or 12 core teams, and then 4 teams were invited, you know, as invitational teams. And those coaches and those teams never really had an opportunity to settle as a team and to grow as a team and learn from their mistakes, and they go from tournament to tournament to tournament, and almost like over a season, then you progress and you improve and you become better as a team, as players and as coaches. Now you have 15 core teams, Canada, Portugal, Spain, and those countries. I mean, now they've been offered the opportunity to progress and to become better. So they've learned from their mistakes from previous encounters, from previous tournaments. They're becoming better. They go back home and they work on their mistakes and where they can improve. And that's why you're seeing the teams becoming so more competitive. And so, yeah, I think we're going to see exactly the same. Whether we're going to keep, you know, or whether those teams that's going to stay there and keep their status, you know, as core teams, whether they're going to be there or not, and whether new teams are going to come in, we're going to see exactly the same status quo. Teams are going to come in, they become competitive, and they're going to upset one or two teams, and I think that's just you know, a warm up for us and what to expect when the Olympic comes in 2016.
It also makes Rugby World Cup Sevens extremely competitive this season. We're only 3 months away now. Is it difficult this season as well, balancing dual aspirations in the World Series and also with the World Cup?
I think it's going to be two separate, you know, tournaments, and I mean, the one is a series and the one is a once-off tournament. And I think a lot of the teams, I mean, going to the World Cup, I mean, they're going to give themselves a chance, because, I mean, they've seen what happened in the previous World Cup. Wales, you know, the World Cup holders. And I think it's for us, there's only one focus. We would like to finish as high as possible within the series, and we would like to win the World Cup. And I think it's going to be no different for any of the other teams there. We can have a couple of weeks after the end of the series where we can actually recover, get hopefully maybe some of the 15 players in and get them acquainted, you know, to our structures and also to adapt to Sevens. And I think we're going to see that. And this is almost like the last opportunity that we can use it as a warm-up and to see whether we can phase 15 players, you know, into Sevens within a short space of time and really see if they can play at this level and they can adapt to the amounts of Sevens. So I think the World Cup is going to be important. All the teams know that this is it. If they want to get it right for the Olympics, this is going to be their last opportunity.